Northern Sweden in a small village outside of Gothenburg. And this is a special episode that I am making because I have finished my Visborg sweater that I have been knitting for quite a while now. And I was thinking about how much I have been knitting from this designer. So I dragged out everything and I brought her books. She has made three books with a lot of different kind of designs, both shawls and socks and mittens and hats and small things. But in her latest book that came out last year, she also included three sweaters. And it is, of course, Erika Åberg, the designer that I have been knitting a lot from. So I wanted to show you what things I have made from her. And I'm sitting outside and the neighbors are... it's a lovely day, so everybody's outside now doing a bit of garden work. And yeah, as you can hear, there are teenagers living next door here and they are playing some music. But I hope I hope it's okay. The first thing that I knitted from her was from her first book, Knit Shawls, this one is called. And I know that this one is in, you can find this book in English as well. And I decided to knit a big shawl. This designer, she lives on Gotland, the island in the Baltic Sea. And she also gets inspiration from nature and the surroundings where she lives. And I visited Gotland and I bought some yarn there, one single yarn. And I knitted a big shawl. It's very, very big. And what you get in the book is more or less just the lace recipe, and then you can make it as big as you want, how long you want and how wide you want. And I had bought, I don't remember now, maybe I bought three balls, 300 grams of this lace yarn, and I wanted to make, knit up everything. So I just decided the how wide I wanted it, and then I just knitted as long as I had yarn. And I also did this French on the sides because I, you know, I like that. I like French on a shawl. So this was last summer I knitted this one, and I had it as a side project because you learn the lace very quickly and then it's just knitting. So that's the first knit that I made from her first book. And I also made, maybe you can remember, because I think I started to do this in English when I was struggling with the coloring of this mittens. And they are also from her first book and they are called Always Mittens, because this is the kind of mittens that you want to use always. So they are called Always Mittens. And they are so lovely. I knitted this in Jameson and Smith yarn. And I love the coloring of this. So autumnal and beautiful. And they are inspired by Latvian mittens, but she has designed this. Yeah, that's the second thing from this book. And I think that's it. Actually from that first book, and there is a lot of beautiful patterns in this one. Yeah, Knit Shawls and some more, it's called. The next book she released was this, Knit Mittens and Socks and some other things. And from this book I have been knitting some small things. Mittens and mitts, mostly mitts, I think, actually. I knitted these mitts and I gave them away for as a Christmas gift. And the next thing that I knitted from this book was the mitts. I got some help here. Yeah, the next mitts that I made from her second book was this that I knitted from leftover yarns from my humulus that I knitted in the beginning of this year. And they are also perfect sized mitts and a little bit longer here, so you get keep a little bit warmer on the wrists, so that's good. Fjell, they are called, like mountain maybe. Yeah, and I have also knitted a pair of socks from this book. I did the first time I knitted these socks, I made it in just some yarn that I had at home, and I couldn't find them now. I know I use them, so maybe they are in the laundry. But I am knitting another pair now, and they are called Hellmark socka. And I have finished the first one. This is a kit that I bought from Indie Dyer, who is working together with Erika Åberg, and it's Tant Kofta. And I have knitted the first part here, and I am soon to do the heel, just a little bit more on this one. So that's Hellmark socka, my second pair. And then I went over to her latest book, Sticka varmt och mönstrat, knit warm and colorful, I should translate it maybe. And the first thing that I knitted from this book was my storm sweater, storm cardigan. And you all know this one. This has became my signature sweater that I am wearing on my podcast on the cover. And it's knitted in a Norwegian spelsau. Very beautiful. Neighbors are walking on the road here, so I have to stop. Yeah, this one, knitted in a Norwegian spelsau, so it's very actually soft, but it feels like it will last a lifetime, so I'm very happy for this one. Stormkofta. The next thing that I made from that book is this, and they are called Flora, Flora is what we have in the nature. Flora mittens, and they were knitted in Rauma Finull, and they became very, very big. So I decided to throw them in the washing machine, and I felted them. So now they are a good size for me. And I actually knitted one pair that became too big, that I felted. And one pair I knitted in commercial sock yarn, and I have given those away for a present. But they became better in size, so I think it was my tension in some way. Yeah, so that's Flora Mittens. The next thing that I made are these long stockings, and they are in the book, they are like half here, and I decided to make them as a long stocking because I think it's nice when you have a dress or a skirt or something that to wear long stockings. And they are knitted in yarn from Lana Grossa, that I ordered, and it's tweed, a tweed yarn, so it's three colors, the rust and the white and the black here. Yeah, so that's höstbruk, like autumn use, I think you can translate it into. So that's also from Erika Åberg. And the last thing that I finished now is this sweater, and it's Visborg sweater. And it's not the usual style that I go for, but I still think I found a style here that I feel comfortable in. So, yeah. And I knitted this one. You have heard about it on the podcast if you have been watching. You have heard about this sweater for a couple of months now. I actually started it in the middle of August, and now it's like 2 months later. So, yeah, it has been a sweater that I have put aside and picked up and put aside and picked up. And I knitted this one in yarn from Järbo. A Swedish yarn company gifted me this yarn because I was supposed to knit another sweater. But I never got around to do that. It was a knit-along, summer knit-along. And then I have been thinking about what can I do instead. So I decided to go for this one. And I think it's a very good decision, actually. A good match for this yarn. And it's a merino, Portuguese and merino. And you knit it with these lifted stitches. So you only knit with one strand at a time, and then you lift up the yellow stitches, you lift on the white rows. So you create this pattern. So it's also a thinner fabric. You don't knit two strands anywhere. So it's a good, I think I can wear it also inside and now outside in the autumn. So it's a good one. I have a long-sleeved t-shirt in under, so for the wind, so I feel comfortable in it outside now. The yarn is called Kamgarn, and it's from Eastex. It's Portuguese merino, but it's dyed and produced on Eastex on Iceland. And here in Sweden it's Järbo that's selling the yarn. So. Yeah, that's my Erika Åberg designs that I have been knitted. It's quite a lot, and I can feel that I am not ready yet. I will keep on knitting from her. This design is also in a hat and in socks, and I will absolutely try to at least the socks, maybe also the hat. It's a lovely way to create a fabric with lifted stitches. It doesn't become so thick, and that's good. Yeah, maybe I shall try to show you. These are the socks. Oi. Yeah. So this is her first book, and her second book, and her third book. Yeah, as you can see, she has made quite a lot of patterns, and there is still a lot that I want to make. So, but I wanted to make a little episode where I show you what I have made so far. Yeah, I hope that you are all well out there in the autumn, and I will see you very soon with a regular podcast again. Bye bye.